Thank you. For the comfort of our performers and patrons, we request that the audience turn off all cell phones and pagers at this time. Unauthorized video and still photography are not permitted in the theater during performances. We ask that you refrain from entering and leaving the theater except during times of applause or intermissions. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy the performance.
Trumpet in the band, and it's my honor to welcome you here tonight for one of our favorite concerts of the year, a holiday celebration, which this year is presented by our friends at Central National Bank. Central National Bank goes all in on Christmas. If you weren't already aware, they host a holiday event each December that features free pictures of Santa, cookies, hot chocolate, and an extra helping of Christmas spirit, and so we're really glad to have their support here tonight for this concert. And full disclosure, I happen to work there, so that may have played a role in how we got the money. Speaking of Santa, I was on the phone with his assistant on my way over here this evening, and she confirmed that he is on the way. He was supposed to be here for the start of our concert, but he got delayed. He spent most of the afternoon, I'm told, on the phone speaking with various suppliers, trying to procure enough coal for the stockings of each member of the college football playoff committee. His assistant did say that Santa might send me a few updates while he's on the way, so if I hear from him throughout the night, I'll be sure to share those with you. With those announcements out of the way, we turn our attention to the music. The piece we opened with tonight was titled Jingle Bells Forever, and if it sounded a little familiar, it's because it's kind of a festive nod to John Philip Sousa's The Stars and Stripes Forever. Our next piece tonight is a celebration of the Jewish holiday of Hanukkah. This medley of Hanukkah tunes includes Hanukkah, the Dreidel Song, O Hanukkah, Rock of Ages, and Who Can Retell? This is a Hanukkah celebration.
Thank you.
you've been to any of our previous concerts, you know that we take a lot of care to program interesting music that pushes artistic boundaries. But sometimes you have to program music that appeals to the masses. You have to give the people what they want. And that's not what we're about to do. Our next piece features our bassoon section, and I'm guessing there are many of you here tonight who, prior to tonight, maybe couldn't have picked out a bassoon out of a lineup, and that's okay. These concerts are meant to be educational. In all seriousness, our bassoon section is incredibly talented, and it's also a very beautiful instrument. This next piece, which is cleverly titled Bassoon, It Will Be Christmas, incorporates a number of well-known bassoon audition excerpts alongside Christmas carols. Some of the excerpts you'll hear include Sorcerer's Apprentice, Mozart's Overture to the Marriage of Figaro, Berlioz's March to the Scaffold, Tchaikovsky Symphony No. 6, and Beethoven's Symphony No. 4. This is Bassoon, It Will Be Christmas. Thank you. knowledge, such a piece doesn't exist yet, but tomorrow I plan to contact James Stevenson, the composer of that last piece, to commission a new work for next year's concert that features another double reed instrument, Oboli Night. Well, guys, I have an update to share from Santa. Good news, he's made it to Waco. I'm just going to read what he sent me, which I hope is okay. He says, just got into Waco with Miss Claus, and we've checked into our hotel. The missus is a big fan of Chip and Joe, so we had to stay at Hotel 1928, although you'd think they wouldn't charge Santa the full room rate. Oh well, we'll be there shortly, hopefully well after the bassoon piece is over. No, I'm kidding. He didn't say that. I added that. Our next two pieces tonight are two Christmas carols from the United Kingdom. The first is Percy Grainger's The Sussex Mummers Christmas Carol, and the second is Albert Davis's Elizabethan Carol.
Thank you.
excited for our next piece tonight, which is a musical setting of the well-known children's story, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas," which was first published in 1823 with the title of A Visit from St. Nicholas. This arrangement by Randall Allen Bass does a great job of matching the music with the story, and we're thrilled to be joined tonight by a dear friend of the band and of MCC, Rob Page, who will be providing our narration. I think you're really going to enjoy "'Twas the Night Before Christmas."
The night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, and hopes that St. Nicholas would soon be there. The children were all nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap, had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to the objects below, when what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer, with a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled, and he shouted, and he called them by name. Now Dasher and Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away. So up to the housetops the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and Saint Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down this chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples so merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry, his droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a round little belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know that I had absolutely nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work. He filled all the stockings and then turned with a jerk. And laying a finger aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose. He sprang to his sleigh and to his team he gave a whistle, and away they all flew like a down on a thistle. Drove out of sight. Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
Text from Santa. They've left the hotel and they're on their way. And like before, I'm just gonna read what he sent. So it started flying up the Brazos on the way to the concert, but the reindeer got a little spooked, and we decided to take an alternate route. Since when did you guys get alligators in the river? But we're still making great time, and we should be there shortly. I wrote back. I know, right? Nobody asked for alligators in the river, just like nobody asked for a bassoon song at a Christmas concert. But here we are. He thumbs down that text. So our next piece tonight is titled Santa's Journey, Bringing Joy to the World. It's a really fun piece with some exciting moments, and it builds to a really climactic conclusion. I think you're really going to enjoy Santa's Journey.
Thank you.
Should have known all those jokes might come back to bite me. We are so thrilled that Santa is joining us tonight. He and Mrs. Claus will be in the concourse after the program ends, and I encourage you to stop by, take pictures, and tell him I got a little carried away tonight with some of my comments, but that I'm usually pretty good. Our next piece needs very little introduction. It's a Christmas staple for the band. It was written by famed composer Leroy Anderson, who, even though this is called Sleigh Rye, ironically enough, he first conceptualized this piece back in 1946 during a heat wave. It was later and finished in 1948, and was first performed by the Boston Pops Orchestra. favorite pieces to perform each year. This is Leroy Anderson's Sleigh Ride. Several members of the band tell Randy Hayes in our trumpet section that he is a great horse, and I never know if they mean it as a compliment. But he does a great job on that horse sound effect, wouldn't you agree? Before I introduce our final piece of the program, I just want to once again say thank you to Central National Bank for their sponsorship of tonight's concert. If you have a business and would like to be a sponsor for an upcoming performance, we do have opportunities available in the spring. And so if you're interested in that, please feel free to reach out to one of us after the concert, and we'll connect you with the right people. I also want to thank our patrons for their support. Their names are listed in your program there. You can become a patron of the band for as little as $25, and those are tax-deductible donations. I also want to thank our bassoon section for being great sports tonight. They sounded great, didn't they? You can give another applause. Lastly, thank you for being here tonight. There's something about this concert that I think I speak for everyone up here, this shared experience of being here this holiday season. It always puts us in the holiday spirit, and so we really appreciate you taking some time to celebrate the holidays with us. Our next piece is a Christmas sing-along. This is the audience participation part of the program. We get to hear how good of singers you are. The lyrics are in your program. We have Angels We Have Heard on High, Away in a Manger, I Saw Three Ships, and We Wish You a Merry Christmas. And to help lead our sing-along, we have a dear friend of the band with us who's performed with us in the past, Edgar Sierra, who's on faculty here at MCC. He has an amazing tenor voice, and he's going to make us all sound better. So that means that everyone should feel really comfortable just singing out. Let the holiday spirit fill you. So thank you again from all of us at the Waco Community Band. We'd like to wish you a blessed holiday season and the happiest of holidays. Thank you again for being here tonight.
Saw three ships go.